Hey everybody, we're here today with a week 4 litter update for our litter of mini Australian Labradoodle puppies from this girl, GiGi. Hi, I'm Claire from Van Isle Doodles, and today's video is our litter update video. And we're starting off today a little bit differently because we have our mama Labradoodle up here. Usually by the time we are at the 4-week update, we don't see our mama Labradoodle so much. GiGi, however, is a very attentive mom. She really adores her puppies, really enjoys being with them all the time, and she was quite anxious to be part of the show. I think really that GiGi just feels that she should be the center of attention. She is the type of dog who does like to be in the middle of everything. She's a bit like her mama Ripple. She loves attention, and she is one of the puppies that gives us the most love in the whole world. Right, GiGi? Yes. So we thought we would just pop her up here on the table for a sec and tell you a little bit about GiGi before we get started on each of the puppies. Then we will go through each of the puppies, give you an update about each of them, what they've been up to, and also what their current weights are. So you can see Gigi's all of a sudden very attentive over in this direction. Hi. And that's because Reynold has just picked up Tiana. So she's making sure that Reynold is holding Tiana properly and just checking to see what all her babies are doing. Now, as for GiGi herself, GiGi is the most excellent housekeeper in the world. Her area where her puppies are is always spotless. There is never permitted to be anything anywhere that is out of line, dirty, nothing. Oh, she's wanting to get down to get to her puppies. So I'll just hold on to her for a sec here. So she doesn't ever mess up the pee pads. She doesn't mess up the blankets. She always keeps everything just precise and exactly the way it should be. And it's also pristine. So the puppies right now are starting to eat solid food. And sometimes that means they wear more of the food than they actually eat. And so they patter around in their area and leave bits of food behind. Not with Mama GiGi. That is all cleaned up immediately. She doesn't allow there to be anything out of place in her area. She's also very attentive to her puppies. She washes them constantly head to toe. She is very attentive to their needs. If any of them are ever squeaking about anything, she's there in a heartbeat. Now, having said all of that, GiGi also is very, very anxious to be with us all the time. GiGi is a people dog. Labradoodles, of course, are affectionate dogs, and Labradoodles have that family dog temperament. And certainly GiGi has that in spades. But this little Labradoodle mama, she is always wanting to be right on your lap and be the one who's getting the most attention. So yesterday we had a little birthday party for one of our grandsons, and GiGi was right in there. She wanted to be the one that was getting all of the love from the grandkids and just wanted to always be enjoying their affection. She also really likes going outside. She loves to run around, and she's a very active girl, and she also really enjoys chasing the ball. And one of her favorite things is to be able to get the ball and take it from her mama Ripple. Yes, that's what you like to do. All in all, GiGi is a great example of a mini Labradoodle all grown up. So we'll put GiGi down and let her go and see her other puppies, even though she wants to stay and see what Tiana's gonna do. Hi Tiana. And now we'll go through each of the puppies in their birth order. So this is Tiana. Tiana is our chocolate and white party girl, and I suspect she also is an invisible phantom. An invisible phantom is one where you can't see the phantom markings because of the party markings, which means they're a try. So this little lady, oh my goodness, she's just a doll. She has the sweetest little personality. You can see she has really nice, good eye contact. She's nice and lively. She's not pushy. She's not worried about anything. She just has the most delightful temperament. And she also has this wonderful blocky body. I love the body on all of these puppies. And this little Tiana really shows off what we like to see in a Labradoodle puppy. Nice, big, square, hefty, sturdy build. Her tail is right where it should be, so it's not flipping over her back all the time. She has nice high ear set, beautiful, nice wide head, short nose, strong stop. And that personality, that is the Labradoodle personality we're always looking for. Now, Tiana is now weighing in at 1.72 kilograms. So she's just doing great in the weight department. And you can hear, I think it's Snow White in the background. They are in their crates, and of course they can see GiGi. And so Snow White is thinking that, oh, maybe it's time for GiGi to come and give me something to eat. And she thought she's calling GiGi. So Tiana, along with all the rest of the puppies in the litter, have, as I said, started to eat solid food. And she's quite good at it. She does like it. She still will nurse from GiGi, and that is still her preference. And she does fall through it quite often. When we come out to see the puppies, they all come running out to the edge of their area to greet us. And oftentimes they will slide right through the pan of food. So it makes for quite a lot of messy puppies. So that's Tiana. Next we have Peter Pan, and there we go, Peter Pan. Hi! Oh, and there's Gigi's coming to take a peek and see what's going on. And you can see, look at this, that tail going 100 miles an hour. This is something I love. This is what we get with GiGi and all these puppies. You get this enthusiastic greeting. They are always so happy to see you. They couldn't be more delighted that there's somebody who's going to come and give them some cuddles. These Labradoodle puppies all love cuddles. They can't wait to be picked up. They love to be have you play with them and stroke them, and just, oh, they're the most, just most affectionate and outgoing and confident puppies. It's wonderful to see. Now, the other thing that the whole litter has done in this past week, besides starting to eat food, is get their teeth. So now when they are on our fingers and our toes, oh, he's starting to be a little bit ouchy. Yes, it is. So they are going to be able to start eating their raw food anytime now. Indeed, these puppies have already all had some raw. We put sometimes Gigi's dish in with her rather than feeding her outside of her area. And they are all quite happy to dive in and see what that's all about. Right now, their main food is goat's milk, pablum, and some pumpkin. But I would expect, oh, probably midweek next week, they'll all be moving over to eating raw pretty much 100%. Peter Pan is the most lively out of all the puppies. He is fun, he is friendly, and he just skedaddles around 100 miles an hour. He's very agile. He's a bit like his mom. He's tinier, but he's also so lively, and he's just always like, okay, okay, let's play. What are we going to do? And that tail, which just mimics Gigi's 100%. Yes, I'm talking about you, Gigi. And Peter Pan is now weighing 1.45 kilograms. So he is not the smallest, the second smallest, but he's definitely smaller than Tiana and Snow White, but just perfectly put together. And he's our little chocolate phantom Labradoodle, just a doll. So that is Peter Pan. Next we have our big bruiser in the litter. Here you go, Pete. And that's Snow White. Hi, baby. Hi. Now, Snow White is a caramel extreme parti. These puppies tend to be very, very beautiful when they grow up. Breeders are constantly looking for all white or as close to all white puppies as they can find. There's not very many of them, and they tend to just be so stunning. And Snow White is no different. You can see that she has lots of love to get moving around. She says, I don't want to stay still. Come on, let's play. Normally when you come see me, you play with me. Oh, 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 you're fine, you're okay. And you can see her beautiful caramel coloring on her ears, and it's also around her eyes. And it may be that she ends up developing a couple of spots on her back too. I don't think so, because we haven't seen any sign of them yet. Can I rub your tummy? Can I rub your tummy? Would that make you happy? Snow White is quite a character. She has a lovely temperament. She has a lot of the qualities from this line that are what we call our therapy type qualities. She's a very intuitive dog. She's also very, she tends to bring out the good in everybody. She's so much fun, and she's such a happy little soul and fidgety that she just makes you want to smile all the time. She's just a happy-go-lucky girl and just so nice to have around. She brightens up your life, and she just makes you always feel better no matter what's going on. And as I said, she's quite intuitive. So if ever you're a little bit tired or if you're a little bit anxious about anything, she always already at 4 weeks old seems to recognize that and come right away to give you a little bit of extra attention. Yes, and you can see she's quite independent. When I was holding her, that wasn't really what she felt like doing, and so she made sure that I was aware of that. She's quite good at communicating, and now that she's sitting on her own like a grown-up dog, she's much happier. So Snow White, our big husky Labradoodle puppy, is weighing in now at 1.2 kilograms. So she is almost already 2 kilograms. So she is going to be a nice, really good size, large mini Labradoodle. Yeah, okay, bye now, yeah. Next we have Goldilocks. So we've gone from our biggest girl now to our smallest puppy in the litter. Hello, sweet girl. Now Goldilocks, this is our gentle soul in the litter. She is the quietest puppy in the litter. She has lots of good confidence, but she is nowhere near as outgoing as the other puppies. She likes to be part of the group. She likes to follow everybody. She's not a leader at all. This is the type of puppy who gets along really well with other dogs. She just wants to be friends, and she wants somebody to be her guide. So she is always looking to the other puppies to kind of point out what should and shouldn't happen. She's very, very affectionate. She just doesn't like to have to be the one who does the first move. She's doing really quite nicely now with eating her solid food. She still prefers to nurse from Mama Gigi, and she's one of these Labradoodles that's going to be like, yeah, I don't know. I may eat today and I may not eat today. That's what she's showing me anyway so far. And she's this really, really pretty caramel color. I love this shade of caramel. It's such a beautiful, beautiful tone. And she has those gorgeous high set ears, beautiful head, and lovely stop. She's a very pretty little Labradoodle puppy, aren't you? Yes, you are. And she's the type of girl who prefers things to be a little quieter. So whereas Snow White is ready for some fun and for some action and would think that hanging around with kids and going swimming and having a great time would be the best day of her life, this little Labradoodle would prefer to be with slightly older adults and just have a very nice, calm, easygoing lifestyle. So that is our little Goldilocks, and she is 1.27 kilograms. There you go, baby. We'll put you back with everyone. She's really quite a sweet girl. So that's all of the puppies from this litter for this week. Next week is our puppy family visit, so we won't have an update video next week. We hope you all enjoyed this one, and give us a thumbs up if you did. Thanks for watching.